Hello guys, in my first video we have seen that how we can add the big F5 in EvenG, right? And we could see the GUI, how we can access through the GUI for F5. Now we are going to add the license into the F5, and we will be going to do the minimum configuration that is required to start the F5, right? Let's do that. So this is the GUI that we can see before adding any license. It says no license exists for this device, and this is an initial setup. We can see the setup utility, and we will be going by all these phases to configure the F5 for the minimum functionality, right? So if you want to set up the, you know, like you want to add the license in the F5, either you can purchase a license from official website, or you can have a trial license from this official website, and you can download it by using this URL. You can go to the URL and you can create, you can log in by your account, and there you can see you can have a 30 days trial for the virtual appliance. Once you register yourself in the F5, once you ask for the 30 days trial, you will get the license key in your register immediately. And once you are done with that, that means now you have a license key and we can good with the installation, right? Now I'm going to click the next button. Let's see, it is asking for the license not activated, and let's activate this now. Asking for the base registration key, and I have this. This is my base registration key, and I'm going manual. Next. So this is a second page when we are adding license. So we can activate it by using the license server, which is of the F5. We can click this. Let's copy this. Copy link address. Open it in your browser. Activate F5 license. And this is a license. Control A, Control C. And paste it here. Next. All right. So this is the license we have now on the F5 portal that we can use in the virtual appliance. All right. They have given me this license. Either you can download it, this license, and upload in the F5 virtual appliance, or you can directly copy paste this. So I have selected all that and pasting in this window, license window. So once you paste all that configuration, all the license configuration, then you click the next button. You can see if everything is going good, then it is loading and receiving configuration data from your device. You can see that now the license is installed, and it will take some time to register the system, and it will come up again, right? Yeah. So when you see this window, don't panic. It will take some time because it is starting again, setting up the web server and everything. So have patience. It will come up again. Okay. And now the process is done. Now you can see when you click the license here, you can see the license is given to this virtual appliance. So we can do all this operation. These are the active modules we have. So I think we are good with this. And going to the next. So on the resource provisioning window, you can see that the state with the license, we can use all these modules of F5, like we can use LTM, ASM, GTM and all these things. And the one with the unlicensed, we cannot use that for our lab, and we have to purchase that officially, right? So in 30 days trial, so they have provided these modules we can use and we can do the practice. For now, I'm going to just use the LTM. So I have just selected the LTM and going to the next window. If you want to practice more, like if you want to use iRules LX, or if you want to use GTM, if you want to use this one and ASM module, so you can select that. So I'm going to the next window. Okay, asking for the device certificates. Okay, so this is a by default certificate. If you want to change anything here, you can renew this, you can import the certificate, so you can modify the certificate which is already existing in the F5, right? The IP address, so this is a management IP address. Keep in mind that you should not change this IP address, because you remember we have configured the management port in the previous video, and there we have configured this IP address. If you change this IP address, then you will lose the connection with the big F5, and then again you have to go back to the CLI and you have to again start from the scratch. You have to configure the again IP address, and then you can start the F5. So do not change anything. You can add another IP in the management port that you want to use for the management purpose, and what is the host name you want to give. Suppose if I want to give the bigiplab.com, okay, so this host name you can see at the tab button of the F5 and the browser, and the user management host IP is all good. If you want to set the password for this, you can set the password for root account. I'm doing that. I'm setting the password, and I want to allow the SSH, the all address. Yes, I want to allow the SSH from all IP address, and we are good. Going to the next platform. Okay, asking for the DHCP. We have to choose everything here. Okay, so password do not match. So once you click the next button, you can see the loading, right? So when you don't see anything here, so that means we are done with that. And this is a configuration, network configuration they want you to do at your end. You can configure the VLAN, NTP, DNS. I'm not going in the detail about talking about all these configuration, because it is a complete detailed discussion we have, and I will discuss in the another class. And for now, I just have added the license, and I will be doing the minimum configuration to start the F5, right? I'm going to the next button. Okay, network failover method. All right. If you want to specify the self IP and the VLANs, you can do that, right? But when you click the next button, it should ask you for the... It is a mandatory field, we have to add that. So I am going to add 1.1.1.1. Network mask is this. Floating IP address 1.1.1.2. VLAN tagging is, I am using the auto tagging. Yeah, okay, tagged. Next. Okay, asking for creating the VLAN. So let's use any existing VLAN we have. internal VLAN that I have created for the self IP, and I'm going to use that. Okay, all done. Next. For the HA, going to use the existing VLAN, not specifying any VLAN for that. All good. Okay. Okay, asking everything for the DNS. No, I'm not going to configure anything here. Next. Configuring. Okay, next. Fill over with the management address. Not required. All right, setup utility complete. We need to refresh this page. Let's do that. Wait for a few moments. All right, we have done the setup utility, and now we can see the modules that we wanted to have in the F5, and we have the LTM over here. We can configure all this configuration, and there are a lot of things to do with the F5 because we have not configured that we can use this LTM. So we have, like, we have to create the VLANs, we have to map the, you know, traffic group, and there are certain things we have to specify before going to the local traffic manager, right? And then when we go to the local traffic manager, then we have a hierarchy of things that first we need to create the node, then we have to create the pool, either we want to use the iRule or not, that depends, and then we need to create the virtual server, and then we can do our labs and whatever we want. So we can do the load balancing, we can use the F5 as a reverse proxy server, and we can use the persistence, SSL cookie persistence, and we can do the F5 for various purposes. So this class is all about for how we can add the license in the F5. We have done that, and we have done the basic configuration, the minimum configuration which is required to start the F5 to see the LTM, and we have achieved that. We can see the LTM now, and this is a basic configuration. In our next class, I will talk about the things that were coming in the first in the while installing all these things, while provisioning the module in the F5, like the floating IP, the self IP, the config sync, the mirroring, the failover. So we will going to discuss all that concept in detail, and we will configure that. And also, when we are done with the complete installation of F5, the device implementation of F5, then we will be discuss about the scenario, like how we can use proper use of the LTM, the GTM, and everything, right? So I think I have done with this thing. And if you have any questions, then please let me know. Thank you.